Welcome, visitor, to this excursion to the University of Western Australia, Perth, WA, May 3rd, 2008. It's West Australia's oldest university, but today it's only one of four, the others being Murdoch, Edith Cowan, and Notre Dame. We approach through a tunnel underneath Stirling Highway. This is the main entrance, but no one uses these steps. The university is very large, a small city with 20,000 students, and it's exceptionally beautiful with limestone buildings and stately trees. This is Winthrop Hall, constructed in 1929. It has beautiful stained glass windows and a large clock that's actually accurate. It's an impressive piece of architecture. A quote from Plato, there's statues and sculptures all around the university. This inscription reads, "The undercroft is dedicated to Socrates, who sought truth always by the path of open discussion and free inquiry. May his spirit preside here at all times." The cornerstone is to honor the memory of Sir John Winthrop Hackett, the first Chancellor of the University, who dedicated the money for the hall. There's loads of ducks in the ponds and peacocks wandering around freely. My niece Britt is to the left, and another friend, Mark Pillage. A Moreton Bay fig tree, which often reaches 100 years of age. It's a very green and stately campus with lots of shade. This area is semi-tropical and is a frequent spot for wedding photographs. The University Library. A view of the arts building. The economics and commerce building. This Japanese garden is very attractive. This wall mural caught my attention. The oldest UWA building was moved here and reconstructed. The Guild building contains quite a number of stores, including quite a good co-op bookstore. Having an honors and master's degree in psychology, this psychology building caught my eye. However, I went to Edith Cowan University. The chemistry building. The university is expanding, mainly upwards, and there's many new buildings under construction. Agricultural science is very important to the agricultural state of West Australia, and is well featured at the university. Research into the problem areas of salinity and dry lands. The large animal faculty caters for such beasts as cows, or horses. Apparently, these are the cooling towers for the air conditioning throughout the university. A mammoth new building for business studies, I believe. Although the university is mainly empty on a Saturday afternoon, these streets and thoroughways throng with people during the week. We explore a taxonomic garden with examples of the flora found throughout West Australia. There are a variety of Banksia trees, and they're always attractive. These unusual, colorful plants are out of my reach. I couldn't get in to see them. I'm not sure what they are. They're quite large in size. Britt took the photograph. She did a great job. Gum nuts are quite prevalent throughout Perth. The Anatomy and Human Biology Building. There's always clubs practicing martial arts skills. We approach the Octagon Theatre. It's used not only for theatre shows, but things like bands and folk singers. During the summer months, films are screened in the Somerville Theatre, an outdoor theatre with stately pine trees. The sun is setting, it's getting cooler, and it's time to go home. This has only been a glimpse of what is really a very large university. Thanks for joining me on this quick exploration, an afternoon wandering around the University of Western Australia. Do have a good day.